It was the first commercially available color film. Before Kodachrome, the world really existed only in black and white. The color images that you see from World War II were almost all captured on Kodachrome film. Kodachrome film was the official film of the coronation of Queen Elizabeth II. Kodachrome is the film that the Zapruder film of the Kennedy assassination was captured on. So Kodachrome really has been one of the films that's preserved the history of the 20th century.
This is Ryan Jones for Newsweek, and I drove halfway across the country with some of the last rolls of the iconic Kodachrome film.
This is my destination, Dwayne's photo in Parsons, Kansas, the last place in the world to develop Kodachrome. I would arrive only days before the last rolls were processed.
Having never shot a single photo with Kodachrome, I decided to travel to Kansas by car, taking pictures of the American landscape one last time with the film that has so poignantly captured Americana over the past 75 years. I began in New York, where I met Christmas revelers in Washington Square Park and people like Sarah Vuth Inn, who is a well-known chess player in Union Square. A 2,000-mile trek lay before me, and I couldn't make the drive without the proper soundtrack. In Virginia, I had to resist the urge to photograph every dilapidated building along Route 51. And in the mountains of West Virginia, my driving abilities were put to the test when a blizzard suddenly descended. On day two, in Paris, Kentucky, I met Pauline of Pauline's Hair Design. One of her clients told me that even if she lived 3,000 miles away, she'd still come to Pauline for all her hairstyling needs. She also told me about Claiborne Farm, which is home to a horse cemetery where champions and Triple Crown winners like Secretariat are buried. Now, of course, no trip through Kentucky would be complete without a stop at a bourbon distillery, and Woodford Reserve just so happens to be my favorite brand. Day three brought us through Missouri, where a drive-in theater and some outside sporting equipment caught my eye. Then came Lawrence, Kansas, home to my alma mater, the University of Kansas, and to some of my old haunts. The final miles of the trip were thrilling and nerve-wracking. I had no idea how these pictures were going to turn out. There was no LCD screen to look at after I snapped each photo, no delete button, and no do-overs. But as I pulled into Dwayne's photo, I was anxious to see my rolls go through the unique Kodachrome developing process. I was anxious also to get to speak with Grant Steinle, Vice President of Operations at Dwayne's Photo and son of the founder of the company.
Dwayne's Photo is a family business. It was founded by my father in 1956, and today we are the last lab in the world to process Kodachrome film. Kodachrome, because the dyes are incorporated when it's developed, it has a unique dye set, so it captures color in a way that really no other film does. That's one of the reasons it's had such a strong following, is that there's a unique look to Kodachrome film. After December 30th, Dwayne's Photo will still be here. We'll still be processing a wide variety of films. We just won't be doing Kodachrome any longer. Kodachrome's a little more than 10% of our business, and so we hate to see that go, but certainly we'll still be here, and we hope to continue offering service to our customers for many, many years.
Right here is your roll of film. The film loops back and forth from the rollers at the top of the tank to the rollers at the bottom of the tank. So it works its way across the tank, comes across, back and forth, back through the machine.
I think the thing that makes Kodachrome unique is really the same thing that's causing it to be discontinued now. That if all Kodak had to do was continue to make Kodachrome film, they would do that. It's because there are all these specialty chemicals they had to make along with Kodachrome. The dye couplers that are unique to Kodachrome that aren't used in any other film, they had this whole infrastructure to support to continue Kodachrome. And so I think that's the reason it was just no longer financially viable for them to continue to make everything that it took to support Kodachrome film.
I had caught glimpses of my slides as they went through the process, so I knew that some kind of image had come through. But the anticipation continued as each frame was slowly scanned into the computer. It was an anticipation that is not experienced in this digital age of instant gratification. Not every frame was perfect, but when one popped up that lived up to how I imagined it would be, there was this unique feeling of satisfaction and relief. I only wonder if, now that the days of Kodachrome have passed and other films seem to be on their way out, will I be able to experience that unique feeling again?
We definitely see the end of Kodachrome as the end of an era. You know, Kodachrome was the first really widely available color film, and so we see its disappearance really kind of emblematic of the end of the era of film capture, the transition over to digital capture. You see a change in how people regard photography. I mean, photography used to be magical to people. You know, they didn't really understand how it happened, and you had to pay money for it and wait for it. In an age where capturing images is instant and they're all free and everyone's phone takes pictures, I think you lose part of the magic.